if he has a high crotch, okay, and he starts to come up with it, right? I'm just gonna leg curl, drop my lower my position, and I'm gonna come across his face, the inside of my elbow, as I drop my position. Boom. Now I've got him in pretty much the same exact position, right there. Right? Okay. Now, and one thing I wanted to bring up too, before you guys go back out, if you go back out, I don't want to do this a lot of times. All right? I don't want to do this. I don't want to break it and then like do this. Right? Oh, that's not a good idea for me. Okay? Especially on this guy because he's got some underhooks. Right? Okay. Here.
And that's a good point right there. You see how the transition, best time to attack sometimes is right when he beats me out of my attack. Watch, I'm still coming in, I'm recovering. He went right to the leg, okay? Watch, that's a good, great transition when we get out there and wrestle a little bit, okay? I'm right here. I'm gonna drive up. I'm gonna go pretty good speed. Not all out live, but watch this, okay? I'm here, I'm driving up.
All I had to do was hit the corner, really. Hit the corner, drive a little bit.
Great transition wrestling, okay? Just like when you're wrestling on the bottom, sometimes best time to get a takedown is right after an escape. One and two, one and two. Anybody's coach ever say one and two? One and two? They have or they haven't? They should be. Okay, I know if they go to corner landing on, I know that guy right there. Heard him say one and two. All right, let's get out, go.